change your mental capacity, change your perspective, change your outlook. That is, your relationship with God has done you no good if your perspective on life has not changed since you've been saved. I want to talk to three or four saved people in the room. And when you really get saved, your perspective on life changes. I mean, when you really get transformed, your perspective on the enemy changes. I don't whine, pout, or complain about the enemy. Elder, when I see the devil getting close, I get happy because my mind has been transformed and I understand that God's going to use my enemy to be my footstool because my mind. If this glass wants some of this tea, it'll never get it. I can pour. But Ezra is being wasted. Oh, God. You waste revelation. You waste experiences with God. When you enter into his presence with high minds and haughty spirits and rebellion and resistance and say, nobody's going to tell me this and nobody's going to talk to me. Yes, I'm talking to you like that because I'm trying to break your spirit because God wants to put a saddle on your back so you can be a vessel and an instrument of purpose. But it won't happen until you bring yourself low. Ah, yes. And you got to make sure that when you receive a little impartation, you don't get beside yourself. And you don't start going back to where you came from. Now, if you knew what was all that was in this cup, you realize that that ain't 5% of what he really want to give you. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you could have got more than what you got. But you got grand too quick. Oh, y'all don't like this kind of preaching. If you really want to keep on receiving from God, you got to stay low. Tell somebody, get low and stay low. Oh, I could jump off the freeway right here. Tell somebody, if you get low and stay low, then when God's word begins to spill from heaven, you'll be able to receive everything. Oh, I hear God talking to you right now. That whenever an individual goes through a heart transplant, a part of the procedure, you got to die. So for 45 minutes, or however long it takes them to give you a new heart, you got to die. But the problem in this New Day church is everybody want to be anointed, but nobody wants to die. Everybody wants to be bishop, but nobody wants to die. Everybody wants to be missionary, but nobody wants to die. Everybody wants the platform, but nobody wants to die. But it's not until you die to the flesh and let God bring you back. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, since I died to my flesh and God brought me back, there's been a great change. There's been a great change. There's been a great change. I'm so happy. I'm so free. Yeah, I'm so glad. I'm so glad. It's a neighbor. You better go under the knife before you die. Tell them, neighbor, submit yourself. Y'all don't like what I'm saying, but I'm gonna tell you what the knife looks like. Here come the knife. Humble yourself. Therefore, under the mighty hand of God, submit yourself under God. Delight yourself in the Lord. Yeah, obey them that have the rule over you. Yes, y'all don't like this. Y'all too grand. Somebody told you you were anointed, but I'ma tell you, you're not anointed. You just sound good doing what you do. Because when you are anointed, demons tremble. When you are anointed, demons flee. We've got in the New Day church a bunch of gifted, talented, demon homeboys. We got a bunch of gifted, talented friends of the devil. But let me tell you that when you get anointed, when you show up, demons start running. When you pray, hell starts to tremble. When you lay hands, sickness got to go. when you lay down and let, if you be willing and obedient, cut you open. When you get cut open, then he'll put, my God shall supply in you. But you can't get, my God shall supply in you, until you let humble yourself, cut you. Y'all don't like what I'm saying. You can't get the blessings until you let the principles cut you. Look at somebody. Ask somebody, neighbor, if you want them, go higher. I dare you to stand up on his word. Because when you learn how to stand on his word, Kim, is the difference between Clark Kent and Superman. When I'm standing on my own, I'm a reporter for the Daily Planet. But when I stand on his word, I can leap tall buildings in a single bound. I'm faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive. When I'm standing on my own, I'm He-Man. But when I stand on the word, by the power of Grayskull, y'all don't like this. I'm trying to tell you, when you stand on his word, you can be like Wonder Woman. Ching, ching. When you stand on his word, you will be like Mr. Freeze. You can freeze all the fiery darts of the devil. When you stand on his word, tell your neighbor, said neighbor, if you stand on his word, this is the Spirit of God in black and white. If you don't have this, you don't have anything to lift up a standard. That's the reason why the enemy is overtaking you. But when you got the word in your heart, when affliction comes, you can put a word on it. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. For our light affliction, which is for a moment, working for us far more exceeding weight of glory. When trouble comes, you give your trouble. Galatians 6 and 17. From now on, let no one cause trouble. When you get weary, put Matthew 11 and 28. Come to me, all ye who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. When you feel all alone, go to John 14 and 16. I will ask the Father, he will give you another helper, that he may be with you forever. That is the Spirit of truth. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to where you are. When your money gets funny, pull out Psalms 112 and 3. It says, wealth and riches are in his house, and his righteous endure forever. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, all you got to do is put a word on it. Put a word on it. Great. Oh, and your way seems hard, but you need to know it's in the will of God. If God says go, go, go. go, go. You better go.